Hey y'all, my name's Amanda. Welcome to my channel. And today I'm going to show you three different methods of holding the yarn in your left hand for continental style knitting to maintain good tension, which is how tight or loose the yarn is in your hand. And I'm going to demonstrate that with a row of knit stitches and a row of purl stitches. When I talk about tension, if you are having tensioning problems, you will notice that your stitches are not even like these are. Your stitches will start to kind of look like different sizes. Some are loose, some are tight. This is purl on the other side. You can see these are nice and uniform. So that's one sign that you have issues with tension, is if your stitches are not looking uniform. Another sign is if you're having a lot of trouble going into the stitch and it's too loose or too tight. So first I'll say that there's no right or wrong way to hold your yarn. Whichever way gives you the tension that you need, which means that the yarn is either tight or loose as you're working the stitches, whichever way you hold the yarn that gives you the tension that you need is the right way to hold the yarn for you. So I'm going to show you three different methods, and you can try each of these and see which one works best. The first method I'm going to show you, which I think is the most common, involves wrapping the yarn around one or both of these bottom two fingers. So to do that, let's start with just the pinky. You're going to take your pinky, put it on the far side of the yarn, about maybe a couple inches away from the hook. You don't want to be way out here. You don't want to be too close, but just maybe a couple inches or so from the hook. You're going to put your pinky on the far side of the yarn, turn your hand, and straighten your pinky out so the yarn goes over the top of your pinky. Some people just stop here and wrap it once, and some people do the same motion again to wrap it twice. Okay, I'll show that again with the ring finger. Again, you can do this with the ring finger or the pinky finger. You want to put your finger on the far side of the yarn, bring your finger up. You can stop there and just have one wrap, and some people do it again and have two wraps. Okay, that's the second way. And then some people involve both fingers, which is you use your pinky to do the first wrap, and then you use your ring finger to do the second wrap. And any one of these may work for you. So I recommend trying all three if you're new to continental knitting and seeing if any of those methods work for you. So the idea with the wrapping is that when your hand is closed all the way and you've got those fingers tight against your palm, you can't pull the yarn at all. And when you loosen those fingers away from your palm, the yarn comes out slow and steady. So if you have the finger wrapped, you have those fingers tied in, you can't pull the yarn, you loosen your fingers and you can pull the yarn out steady. Okay, so that's step one of the first way. You want to wrap it around either one of these fingers. Next, you're going to take your pointer finger and put it between the yarn and the needle. Stick it straight in there. I've got my ring finger bent back. I'm sorry, my middle finger bent back. Put the yarn between your finger between the yarn and the needle, and then just straighten your finger out. And then use your middle finger and your thumb to hold this needle. And you have maybe an inch or so of yarn sticking out there. Okay, I'm going to show you that again. You do this part where you wrap around your pinky. You pull your other three fingers in towards your palm. Take your pointer finger and put it between the yarn and the needle. Underneath, turn your hand, keep that finger, that pointer finger straight, and then use your ring finger and your thumb to grip the needle. That is method number one for holding your yarn for continental knitting. Method number two is similar, except you don't wrap the yarn. You're just going to use kind of like a pinching motion to hold the yarn close to your palm with these bottom two fingers. And again, I'm just going to put these two fingers on the far side and pull them in to my palm. The idea, same as before, is if your fingers are locked into your palm, you can't move the yarn. If you loosen your grip, the yarn comes out nice and steady. Okay, so once you have this pulled in, the next part is going to be the same as the previous way of holding your yarn. You're going to bring this middle finger in, straighten out your pointer finger, between, stick it between the yarn and the needle. Turn your hand and keep that pointer finger straight. And then use your middle finger and your thumb to grab the needle. Okay, and see that my middle finger is staying on this side of the yarn. It's staying on the side of the yarn that's closer to my body. So I'll demonstrate that again. You put these two fingers on the far side of the yarn, pull it in towards your hand, middle finger down, pointer finger straight, stick it between the yarn and the needle, keep it straight and turn your hand, and then take your middle finger and your thumb and hold the needle. So that's method number two. Okay, method number three is a little different. Method number three is actually the method that I use, and it doesn't really involve these bottom two fingers at all. It's really all happening kind of in this space between your pointer finger and your middle finger. So for that one, you are going to use these fingers to pick up the yarn. Okay, you're not going to pinch it or anything, but you're going to pick up the yarn with these bottom three fingers and pull it in. Okay, and this is just to get it out of the way, to set it on your hand. You're not really going to continue this motion when you're actually knitting in this way of holding the yarn, but you want to just grab it with those three fingers. And then the next part is the same. You just point your finger, stick it between the yarn and the needle, turn your hand, and then you let go. And again, this may be easier or more difficult for you. You hold it with these three. And now I'm going to let go with these bottom and use all three of these fingers to hold the needle. And all of my tension is right here, just pinching between the pointer finger and the middle finger. And that's just the easiest way for me. So I'm going to wrap these three around to get the yarn out of the way. Pointer finger in this gap, turn my hand, and then I'm going to use all three of these bottom fingers to hold the needle, and my yarn tension happens right here where it's coming between my pointer finger and my middle finger. So try any or all of those methods and see which one feels the most comfortable for you. And this one, I do keep the yarn kind of right at these knuckles. But again, you could probably hold it closer up to the palm of your hand or inside of your back of your hand here, if that's easier for you. So now I'm going to demonstrate to you what proper tension looks like so that you can tell with whichever one of these methods that you're trying, if it's working or not, if it's a good tension for you or not, okay? So I'm going to demonstrate that with a row of knit stitches and then go back the other way and demonstrate with a row of purl stitches. I'm not going to teach you how to do the knit and purl. I do plan to do videos on those in the future, but this is really just a guide if you're sort of familiar with how to do the knit and purl stitches to be able to tell if your tension on your yarn is good or not as you're learning or working on those stitches. So depending on your method, your finger's going to be the same no matter which way you're doing it. This finger's going to go under the yarn and hold it straight, and this finger is going to stay straight the whole time. Your pointer finger and your left hand is going to stay straight the whole time. You're either going to be holding like this if you're using a method that has these bottom two fingers involved, or if you're doing the way I do, you're going to be holding it with all three of those fingers. But the idea is you can kind of pluck this yarn here like a guitar string and it doesn't move. You don't want it to be loose so that happens, okay? If that happens, it means that your tension is too loose. If I can just put my finger on that and it comes out that way, the tension is too loose. Or if I push it and it just won't move at all, then it may be too tight. But you want to be able to kind of pluck it like a guitar string, okay? So for a knit stitch, you're going to insert your needle right here in the front of the stitch. Okay, to do that with this method, it actually is a little helpful to kind of push down with your middle finger to get under just this first strand. I find that's helpful for me because if I don't, then I catch myself kind of going through this loop here, which is not where the needle needs to go. So that's just another tip. If it's helpful, you can push down on this with your middle finger, push kind of on the back side of that stitch, and it helps you get the yarn in just that first loop. So if your tension is set correctly, then you should be able to pull the yarn through, and watch what happens here, through and off the needle, and it moves just a little bit between your fingers. So I'll show that again and kind of watch where the tension is coming there. So stick it through, and this yarn has not moved. It's just available there for me to pull on it. And then it moves just, whoops, it moves just a little bit between my fingers. See that movement as I'm doing the knit stitch? I'll show you again. The movement actually happens right here if you kind of want to see what that looks like. So I'm going to go into the knit stitch. And then as I pull the stitch through, you can see the movement over my finger. And I'll show you what it looks like if your tension is too loose. So if my tension were too loose, I would insert here. And then this just, see how that just totally falls apart? And I can't get a good, see that's sticking up off my finger? Okay. That's a sign that your tension is too loose if there's a really big sag there. And if you do that, that makes it hard. You can see how big that stitch gets. And then when I go to do my next stitch, there's way too much yarn. So that's a sign that it's too loose. A sign that your stitch is too tight, your tension is too tight, is if you insert and you just can't pull at all. You can see I'm pulling to try to get that through, but this is so tight on my finger that I can barely get it through. Okay? So you want this movement, if you'll just watch right here as I knit, you want this smooth movement of the yarn over that straight pointer finger. And if it's moving in that sort of slow, steady way, you know that your tension is correct. If it's coming like this, and it's kind of popping up off your finger, that means that your tension is too loose. I'll show you that again, what it looks like when it's too loose. If I pull down and there's just a ton of give, it's kind of flopping there, it's not staying tight against my finger, that means your tension is too loose. And if you try to pull and it just won't move at all right here, it's stuck, then your tension is too tight. So I'm going to finish this row, and if you'll just watch right here how the yarn moves between those two fingers to show you what your tension should look like as you're knitting a row with continental style knitting. Okay. I'm gonna go around the other way and show you the same thing with the purl stitch. So the tension is gonna look the same with knitting and with purl, but it's a little trickier with purl because this finger is going to move a lot more. All right. So purl, the first thing you want to do is move your yarn back to the front of the needle. And be careful when you do this. If you pull straight up, so here's your stitch. Here's your first knit stitch. But when I go to hold my yarn, see how it pulls up the sort of the bottom of the previous row. You want to be careful and make sure you're working into this loop here, into this stitch, and not into what pulls up onto the needle when you pull back. Okay, so you want to work into this stitch. So to do the purl stitch, you're going to do the same thing, whichever method you want to grab with these two fingers, or if you're doing the method I do, you're just going to pinch here. But either way, this finger goes between the yarn and the needle, and you're going to hold with either these two or all three of these fingers, okay? And push this down. So in a purl stitch, you're going to push down. And some people push down with one finger, just one that way, and some people push down with two. I personally push down with two. And I'll kind of show you both ways, but you're going to push down. Insert your needle from this side of the stitch, from the right side of the stitch this time. And then wrap and pull up and pull through. So that's the purl stitching, and I'm not really going to do a tutorial on that one, not in this, at least not in this video, but watch my tension throughout this stitch. So here my tension is just like it was with the knit stitch, and my yarn's going to be in front of the needle. Push down and go in, and right now my tension, I can feel sort of it's a firm strand of yarn going across the tip of my finger. It's not loose, not too loose, not too tight. So I've inserted it into the stitch, tip back, it's kind of like a rocking motion, tip back, and again this is still kind of firm on my finger, and then pull through. And you can watch as I slip the stitch off the end of the needle, watch right here. It's going to look just like it did in the knit stitch, where it's very slowly coming across the top of your finger. So I'll demonstrate that again. I'm going to push down with either both fingers or just one finger, and push it down. Go in to the right side, closest to this tip of the needle. Kind of rock back, rock forward, and then watch as it slides off that finger. Slides just a little bit. Right here, this yarn is taut like a guitar string, okay? Tip forward, yarn in, needle in, tip back, tip forward, and watch it on my finger because that's where the tension happens. Knit through, I'm sorry, purl through, and pull, and it comes just a little bit off that finger. So I'm gonna work some stitches slowly so you can see how my tension goes with each stitch. You can see it's coming just slowly, kind of a steady flow of yarn over the top of that pointer finger. And when I do this first tip where I kind of tip my hand down, there's not a lot of movement in the yarn. There's not really a lot of yarn coming through there. The yarn movement kind of happens at the moment that you slide the needle off. I'm sorry, slide the stitch off the end of the needles when the yarn moves a little bit. And that's true for knitting and for purl. So at the end of the stitch is when a little bit more yarn comes through and is available. Up to the end of this row. And there you go. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would love it if you could give it a thumbs up and would consider subbing before you exit my channel. Thanks for sticking with me. Hope to see you next time. Bye.